going to be pinning what I'm making tonight. Making some roasted chicken Cobb salad with cilantro lime dressing. Both things are on my blog. Hi! How's everybody doing? We had an adventurous day, didn't we? But it's okay. We're here for the food, and I'm here to hang out with you guys. Thank you. So let me know where you guys are joining in from, and then we're gonna kinda get going because it's 6:49 and I gotta make dinner. I wanna try to get this done in under an hour. And usually things like this take a lot faster just because I'm answering questions and showing things, which I love doing. Usually takes sometimes a little bit longer. But let me show you guys what we have. Let's see, flip the over. I have four chicken breasts that are bone-in, skin-on. I'm gonna be adding some of this onion salt and olive oil. So that's gonna be the first thing we're gonna do. And then we're gonna just prep the veggies. And then the next thing we're gonna do is we're going to cook the eggs in the Instant Pot. So I'll show you guys how to use that and how to cook perfect hard-boiled eggs. And I'm making extra, you definitely don't need 12, but I kind of wanted to do egg salad for tomorrow, so great time to do that. Then we're gonna be cutting up cucumbers, radishes, tomatoes, avocado, some romaine lettuce, and then we have some arugula in here. And then we're gonna make a cilantro lime dressing. I made some homemade mayo yesterday. We might actually need a little bit more, we'll see. So we'll be making homemade dressing as well. The recipes are both on my blog and I did swipe up links for them before I did. So you can totally check it out and I'll probably do another one after just to kind of show you guys again. So let's get cooking. The first thing we're gonna do is, I'm gonna wash my hands actually. No, actually, I just washed my hands. Never mind. So first thing we're gonna do is prep our chicken to go in the oven. The chicken is bone-in, skin-on chicken breast. Best recipe ever for chicken. If you like chicken breast, this is the only chicken breast recipe I use and cook it only this way. It's my favorite. Comes out super delicious and super easy to make for like prep or whatever you need to do. So I'm making a little extra because I want to be able to have some tomorrow for lunch. So I'm literally going to just drizzle a little bit of olive oil. And you don't need much because the chicken has its own fats. We're just gonna massage in some of the olive oil. Hey guys, how are you guys doing? Let me know where you guys are joining in from. And what'd you guys do for dinner? Tonight's kind of a late dinner for us. But it's gonna be a good healthy one and it's keto approved and Whole30. So if you're doing either, and I guess paleo, I don't really know, I've never done paleo, so I don't know. I think it's close to keto and all that, so. Sacramento, Minnesota. Okay, so let's see if I can do this with one hand. Yep. Okay, so I'm using this onion salt from Trader Joe's as my seasoning for the chicken. That's it, you don't need anything else. So I'm just going to add this on. Make sure it kind of gets in all the nooks and crannies. Because this will create the flavor for your chicken. And it'll have this like very nice fresh flavor. Very springy, and this is made with green onions, so it's not like the onion salt that's like super salty, so you don't need a lot of this. Portland representing. I'm gonna flip this over, do the same thing on this side, but I'm actually going to add it, I'm gonna lift the skin a little bit. Yes, I guess, but I guess Whole30 is more, not really about weight loss. It's more about, like resetting your food, having like food freedom and all that. I've done Whole 30 like 5 times and I'm back on keto the second time, and I actually personally enjoy keto more, and I've lost weight doing keto more than I did with Whole 30 person. That's my personal opinion. So, you know, everybody's bodies are different and how you lose weight and all that stuff. Men obviously, you know, lose weight a lot quicker. So I'm just lifting the skin and adding some underneath. Okay, I'm gonna pop these in the oven, 375 for about 35 to 40 minutes. Some of these bigger ones might take 45 minutes. So bigger meaning like this is a big guy. So I will probably cook this for about 45 minutes. This guy's a lot smaller compared to that one. So you kind of feel it, like two of these are a little bit smaller and one's couple are a little bit bigger. So we'll cook them from like 35 to 45 minutes, and I'll kick up the heat to like 450 just to crisp up the skin really nicely. So let's get this in. My oven's preheated already. And I decided I'm not gonna add any bacon, or maybe I will. We'll see. Wash my hands real quick. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put the eggs to cook in the Instant Pot. So I'll take you guys closer to the Instant Pot. Hey girl. It's a big gal. She sure is. Okay, so I'm gonna put you guys where my Instant Pot is. Okay, and then I wanted to show you guys a tip that I learned from another blogger, is to put your Instant Pot on some sort of surface in between your actual like kitchen counters, because I've heard bad stories of people's counters cracking. So whenever you use your Instant Pot, put some sort of wooden surface underneath it. No, I do not have plural recipes, but I know Natasha's Kitchen and I think Mom's Dish does. I don't really cook that much Russian food, so. But they do, and I've heard Natasha's Kitchen Instant Pot plov is pretty good. I just don't really cook that much of Russian food, so unfortunately. I only enjoy plov when my dad makes it when I go visit them. So, but I've never actually made it myself. I feel like those kind of things I kind of keep as enjoyment that my family members make, you know. Stick to your strengths. I'm not a baker, so I don't say that I bake. Okay, so I have, I'll show you guys in a second. I have like a little insert, like a rack here. So I put a cup of water and 12 eggs. And these are just straight from the refrigerator. Now I'm gonna close the lid. And I'm gonna let it come to pressure. I'm gonna do manual. And I'm gonna do 4 minutes. Because I want them to be hard boiled. And that's just gonna do its thing. Hi. Instant Pots are great. Thank you, Lena. Yes, that's for sure, eat them. One day I will write a cookbook, one day. I think I might start with an ebook. Okay, so those two things that take the longest, while the chicken takes longer, are gonna be hanging out and doing its thing. Right now, let's make the dressing. The dressing, I have it written out for myself because I haven't made it in a while, but it's super easy. It's 1/2 cup of mayo, 1 large lime, 2 garlic cloves, 1 teaspoon of mustard, and 1/4 cup of cilantro. This is my recipe from the Cobb Salad blog post. So I have about 1 cup of mayo. I made this yesterday, day before yesterday, on Monday on live. What's my favorite recipe I've created? Probably the steak. So if you guys have not tried my ribeye steak, that's roast, like cooked in the oven first for like low and slow, and then you just pan fry it or pan sear it after, or you can put it on a grill. If you have not tried that recipe, like hands down, one of my favorite recipes to make, and it turns out perfect and delicious every single time. So let's start making the dressing. I'm gonna be using my immersion blender to blend everything up. This is probably my most used small kitchen tool besides like a knife. So I use this a lot to make dressings. I make mayo with it and everything in between. Okay, so I'm gonna get 2 cloves of garlic. Let me know if you guys have questions and I'll answer them as I go. How's everybody's day going? Did you guys do anything fun today? It's like talking to myself. And after this live is done, I save it and then I'll post it on my YouTube channel. So what am I making? I have it pinned right here. Roasted chicken Cobb salad with cilantro lime dressing. It's gonna be super good. I just popped the chicken in the oven at 375 and I have chicken breast that's skin on and bone in. And I just have some olive oil and onion salt. Oh, it's raining here too. Not like crazy, but raining. It's like drizzling. But California needs good raining. The brand of my hand blender. It's Cuisine Art. I'll do a swipe up link for you guys after if you would like. So I'm just kind of slicing this. What kind of detox are you doing, Elena? Where's my water? I'm drinking water, by the way. I started doing keto again. Which I love, by the way. Okay, so it calls for full lime. I'm just gonna use whatever, this is almost a full lime. If I need a little bit more, I'll add in more. I'm just gonna squeeze this in here. Yeah, what detox are you doing? Are you doing like a juice cleanse or something? Have you guys ever completed a 30-day juice cleanse? I have, many years ago. I do, lenaskitchenblog.com. Says it in the name. That's where my recipes live. Squeezing this lime. Just kind of going on my fingers, massaging the juices out. Good, I was wondering if on keto I'm doing a slim detox. I mean, smoothies 3 times a day in between. You can snack. I'm trying not to be. Hi, baby. Say hi.
Hello.
There's my sexy husband. Pause because, okay. Did the juice help you lose weight? Yes. I mean, this was a lot of years ago. Probably, let's see, Francesca was 8 years ago. Whoops, we're still on the ceiling. I think it was like 8 years ago. I did it for 30 days and I took 2 weeks off and I did it for another 2 weeks. I really enjoyed it. Once like you get into the rhythm of just doing juicing, I also worked out 6 days a week for 2 hours. So that was, yep, This is the only rosé I'm having right here, is the rosé colored glass with water in it. I think I lost like 35 pounds and I probably like gained some of it back like within a couple of years, but I mean, I was kind of pretty good with it. My kids are not, my stepson is a little bit, but he's getting better every day that he's with us and he's trying new things. So I'm gonna add in some cilantro, calls for a quarter cup. I'm just gonna call that quarter cup. And then I need, let's see, mustard. So 1 teaspoon, about 1 teaspoon, sounds good to me. I have a feeling we're probably gonna need more lime. Okay, so let's blend. I think I'm gonna add a tiny bit of olive oil because it feels a little thick in there. Now I'm just gonna blend. Yeah, I love my fridges. So I have drawer fridges. I have 4 of them. I'll show you guys a little bit later. Hi. Let's see. All right, let's just blend away. Just making sure everything is really, really blend. Yeah, I'm definitely, that's the way why I'm not a blender. Oh, we'll need salt. For sure. Yep. Oh, that's limey. You know what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna add a little avocado in here because I'm doing keto and I can't do any sugar. I feel like it needs a little bit of creaminess, so I'm just gonna add like half of small avocado. Do you guys make your own dressings? Do you like making your own dressings? I know, I'm so happy to hear that. I think your dad put your phone on there for a reason, Tyler. Oh, okay. Kids should be done watching. So. Hey, Nikita, Francesca. Time to be done. You guys can play a game now. All right, after 6 minutes, you can play a game.
Kids are watching something.
Oh, I think homemade mayo is the best. Okay, need some salt, and then let's blend this puppy up. I've never made ketchup from scratch, but I definitely make. But we don't really do ketchup that much. This is the only ketchup I will buy. And it has tomatoes, tomato paste, organic cane sugar, onions, distilled vinegar, water, salt, lime juice, concentrate, green bell pepper, and allspice. If you've never tried Sir Kensington ketchup, their ketchup is the best. It tastes like tomatoes. It's so good. Okay, let's blend this puppy up a little bit more. I'm just gonna get some of the stuff from the sides. So dinner time, yes, my family is gonna be eating keto. Breakfast, sometimes Shay will eat with me, but he's not doing keto. No. And then my kids will have whatever for sandwiches or whatever for lunches, so. Okay, that's good. I liked the addition of, I liked the addition of the avocado in there. Made it nice and creamy. I bought the ketchup, I think New Seasons, Whole Foods carries it. And I think Fred Meyer does too, I can't remember. Cause some of them carry some of their products, like they do mustard, they do mayo. I've never tried either of their stuff like besides ketchup, but my friend got me on it. And now that's the only ketchup I ever buy. But I mean, we have like our ketchup lasts for like a couple years cause we don't eat it that often. Like with burgers and fries, but like, you know, that's rare. Just getting all this goodness off. Okay. Dressing is done. Next, let's prep the veggies. I'm actually gonna get a bowl ready for my eggs. His eggs will be done in 2 minutes. So I'm hard boiling the eggs in my Instant Pot. I have not hard boiled eggs in a pot in I don't know how long. Always comes out perfect and peels super easily. So I'm just gonna get some cold water ready in here for the eggs. Aw, thank you, girl. Oh, video's breaking up. Okay, I'm sorry. Hey, Laura. Oh, thank you. I'm not here to offend anybody, but if I learn something that, you know, has possible damaging things to people, I'll talk about it. And that's the whole point of having, you know, my feed is that I can be myself, you know? Cause you gotta do you, boo. That's how I call it. All right, I'm gonna let this stop beeping, do the release. I'm going to get slotted spoon. So this took like no time, and then your eggs will come out perfect every single time. I share things that I find that are interesting to me. So if I find something and, you know, my friend is a nurse, so she shared stuff, I will trust her more than a product. I've never used it. It hasn't affected me. My sister has used it, and I'm not even gonna really bring it up. Whatever. Let's not waste time on people who are negative. So, aw, I love you too, girl. Come on. All right, this is done. Look at this, eggs not cracked. Perfect. So I'm just gonna get them out. Couple at a time. Gently put them in my cold water bowl. Oh my gosh, I forgot to set the timer on the chicken. That's okay. Well, I'll give it like, okay, I'm gonna set the timer. I have my little oven here. So I think it's been cooking for like, I don't know, let's say 10 minutes. So we're gonna do, let's say 20. So this would be like 40 minutes they'll cook. And it's cooking on convection at 375. He Yeah, exactly. No worries. Okay. Let's chop up the romaine. And I'm doing I'm doing mainly romaine and then doing some arugula. So I'm just gonna cut off, let's see. Cut off the end, put it aside, and I'm gonna do like smaller slices because I want it to be easier to eat. This in my bowl. Hey girl. If you guys are just joining in, let me know where you guys are joining in from and what'd you guys do for dinner or how's your day? Tell me anything interesting that's happening in your life. Do you have anything exciting to share? Like good news? Hopefully nobody has bad news to share. Hi guys. And I'm gonna wash this because I don't think these have been washed. So I did like 1.5 heads. I'm gonna grab my washer. I'm so hungry too. Yeah, they eat a snack. Usually like either some like cheese and meat, they'll have some crackers, kind of this, different things. Broccoli and cheddar soup. Ooh, yeah, filet mignon, girl, you are living it up. I just don't like, I don't know, I just don't like the tops as much. I don't even know why. I just don't like them. I have always thrown them away. So, yum. Aw. Oh girl, root canals suck. Okay, I'm gonna get this washed really quick. Oh, awesome. I'm so glad that you tried that. The salmon from Monday's Live. All right, just gonna do my salad spinner. Okay. Let's get this bad boy out. I'm so happy to hear that. You had Uzbekistan stew. What does that have in it? Does it come with rice? Thank you. What are those for? What do you mean, Alicia? So I'm just putting... the sweatshirt is, I'll have to look at the company, but there's like different bloggers that contribute to them. And this blogger that I follow, Arrows and Bows, she designed this part, Simplify Your Life. And I mean, you know, Simplify Your Life. That's, I love that. The salad spinner is OXO. So I just added some arugula into my mix here, and I'm kind of gauging like this much for adults. Maybe we need a little bit more arugula, and then between three kids, beef, onion, carrots, and cumin, garlic. Ooh, yum. That's the salad spinner. So I wash my lettuce with it. Or I've actually done latkes and I've spinned potatoes in it to get any of the liquid out after you wash it. So it's like a salad washer spinner. So you spin out all the liquid out of it. So I just have a big bowl of finely chopped arugula, or no, not arugula, romaine, and then arugula, baby arugula. I'm gonna set that aside. Okay, and now let's just prep the veggies. And I'm just gonna be cutting things. I'm gonna cut the potatoes kind of at a angle. So see how I kind of did that? So I'm gonna do that. And these have been washed, so just in case it is gonna ask me. And I'm gonna lay this out on a platter after I toss the lettuce and kind of do little areas. This should be, I don't think Tyler eats tomatoes. So let's say one, two, couple more. The first time around when I did keto, I lost 16 pounds. I'll probably gain some of it back, but not all of it. I haven't stepped on the scale. But my clothes still feel good, so that kind of, you know, works for me. I'm gonna cut the radishes next. I'm gonna do about 3 radishes, and I'm just gonna cut them really, really thinly. So I just cut it in half, and I'm gonna just finely slice it. You can do them in like matchsticks, that's totally fine too. I put everything in kind of little piles. Nope, nobody asked me to do keto. I just wanted to do it myself. My friend was doing it and she inspired me to try it and I loved it. Like, I don't know why I waited so long to try it. I thought it was gonna be a lot harder, but I've completely loved it. What inspires me the most about doing keto or like food-wise? Natasha, so I have probably like 3 favorite knives. Actually, let's say 4. So this is probably my most used knife. I'll do a link for this. This is my second most used knife. They're both Shun. And then these two, like this is a cheaper version of a, these are both chef knives. They work the same. This one is a little bit better if you're like doing a lot of rocking, like chopping. This one is just a really good knife. Like this is about $400, it's about $150, but you know, if your budget can't let you, if you can't afford one, I would say go for Zwilling. And then this bread knife. So these are like, if you need to buy, new knives, don't buy a set. You don't need a whole set. I would say if you can afford it, like get these 3 knives and that's it. You don't need any other knives. But, you know, that's just my opinion. And I can do the links to them after we're done with live. If you want. So, I like this one for, oh, look at who Cuisine Art is on. Look at what I'm using, my Cuisine Art. I love your guys' stuff. So I should have gym 3 months ago and haven't lost weight. I have to go there sometime to find out why. That's awesome. Okay, so I just cut my cucumber into slices like this. We should do, you guys are in Canada. You guys should send me a DM to your contact for America, Cuisine Art America. Maybe we should do a giveaway for all the lovely people that are on. So I'm just slicing these up, again, very finely for the salad. Oh, don't feel sorry. I love cooking, honey. I enjoy it. This is my relaxation. Yeah, you don't need a lot of knives to, I could probably live with two knives. And I mean, the bread knife is great to have. You don't need like a super expensive bread knife. But I think if you buy good quality knives, you will have them for a lifetime if you take care of them. A, never put your knives in a dishwasher. That's like a big no-no because that actually ruins your knives, especially ones that have like wood handles. That damages your knives and actually makes your knives not sharp. So definitely one knife you're using to chop. Okay, I'll do the links to the knives after this, after the live. This one is great if you're doing like very like fine chopping because it's super, super thin. And I think this knife runs about 150-ish, 175 maybe. So, all right. I did a little extra cucumbers because Tyler likes cucumbers. All right, now we need, bacon. Let's cook up some bacon. Yeah, you know, I don't even I have paring knives, but I don't ever use them because I use this as my paring knife because it's not huge. I mean, let's see. I have this as my paring knife, so you could tell, paring knife. This is really good for fish. I mean, I have like a cleaver for if I have to like butcher whole like meat or chicken or something. But otherwise, I mean, for me, like, I don't think you need whole bunch of different knives. All right, I'm gonna cut up some. Yes, I'll link this knife for sure. I would so completely go with that, yes. And you know what? I actually used to own knives from like an Asian market and they were $4 knives and they were amazing. So if you don't have the money, if you're like a college student, the knives are $4, $6 and $4. Super sharp, amazing knives. So go to our Asian market, they have really good knives there. If you wanna start out there and like you can't afford it, because that's what I used to have in the beginning. And they worked great. I'll show you the knife organizer really quick. And then let's get to the bacon because I'm gonna be able to be done. So I have the Shun knife organizer. I can do a link for that too. And these are like my most used tools in the kitchen. I have like a secret drawer. So that's like my most used pots and pans. That's like less used, most used, and I have that secret drawer. So I've shown you guys this pan before. It's my favorite. It's by Ballerini. I have two of these. So you guys have seen me use that a lot. I have not tried. Somebody asked me about that. I've never even heard of Rada knives. I'll have to look up, Angela, what station is. I don't remember. It was like something chill. I don't remember. Just chose something on Spotify. I'm gonna cut up some bacon. Like evening chill or something like that, I forget. I'll look it up and I can do like a link to it if you guys want after. Oh, I love Marie Kondo, guys. She is awesome. Yeah, I don't like the big blocks that come with, like, you know, the set. Let's do a piece of bacon per person. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, just in case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do 6 slices, even though we have 5 people, but I know people want a little extra bacon. Oh, how do I sharpen my knives? So I'll show you guys after I wash my hands how I do it at home. But I actually give my knives maybe like every 6 months to my friend's son, who's, I think he's 17 now. They live in Camas. Don't be grossed out. I do eat bacon like this. I've never used Rada, but I have my favorite peeler. I don't have a brand. It's the best. It's so thin. I got it on Amazon. So I'm gonna add in my bacon. I'll lay it out. And I sliced my bacon into like 1-inch pieces. Got about 3 minutes and then maybe about 10 minutes on the chicken. After the bacon's done, I'm gonna peel the eggs. Well, actually we can peel the eggs while the bacon's cooking. Just separating it. Done. And I know, knives wise, I know people swear by global knives. I've never owned global knives, so I have no idea. Like, I can't recommend something I've never used. But I have Shun, which is a Japanese company, and Zwilling. So that's the 2 knife brands that I have and use every day. Okay, almost done, guys. Just gonna pile this on top. While I was not looking, let me know. Okay, I'm gonna let that cook and do its thing. Let's peel some eggs. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys how easy these eggs peel. What I like to do is I like to tap in the middle all the way around, gently. And then I like to peel my eggs underneath the water because for some reason it just peels easier and better that way. I mean, look at this. Perfectly peeled eggs. And that's in an Instant Pot for 4 minutes. So I'll do 3 eggs because, well, actually 4, never mind, because my stepson doesn't eat eggs. So again. And you can also press gently like that. We should be able to, let's see. I just like to at least start it underneath the water. Or whatever, I guess we'll just... The water, I guess, helps to release the skin. And I just kind of wash the egg. Make sure there's no, like, membrane. Okay, my chicken is beeping at me. I'm gonna turn this down to low. Get some tongs. I'm gonna show you guys what the chicken looks like now. Look at this chicken. That's been 35 minutes. So I'm actually going to just test this out. Just for a good measure, I'm just gonna use a meat thermometer to check the chicken. And I'm gonna separate my bacon here, flip it over. I don't want to burn it, so I just turn down the heat a little bit. The bacon. And I'm being gentle because I'm using metal not to scratch my pan. So I'm just separating these guys a little bit. Look at that chicken. Doesn't it look good? I'm so hungry. Water. Okay, meat thermometer. All right, I'm gonna stick it into like the thickest part of the chicken and it should read 165. If it doesn't, I'll put it back in the oven. Do its thing. Let's peel more. Look at this. Moment of truth. Easy peel. If you guys have not made Instant Pot eggs, you need to try it. Just wiping these dry a little bit. So I just need 4 eggs, and it'll be like 1 egg per person for the salad. Bacon's almost done. I got 1 more egg to peel. Let's see. I cooked them for 4 minutes on high pressure. And I have the recipe on my blog, so for Instant Pot eggs, they're deviled eggs. So if you look up Instant Pot eggs on my blog, you'll find the recipe on there. And I can do a swipe up link after that. So I'm just gonna cut the eggs in half and show you. So I like mine a little bit under, so if you wanted to cook them even more, I would do 5 minutes. So, got perfect eggs. Like more like medium hard boiled, not overly. Because I'm adding it to a salad, I wanted it to be a little bit under. Like if I wanted them to be a little bit more runny, I'd probably do 2 minutes. Okay, we're at 140 on this big boy. Just gonna remove my bacon onto a paper towel. And then I never get rid of my bacon grease. I have like a little jar by my stove here. And I always save my bacon grease and I strain it. Because then you can use that to cook eggs, potatoes, other meats. Like you can rub that all over chicken. You know, like bacon flavored chicken. I mean, yes please. I have a few pieces here that need a tiny bit more time. So I'll let them do their thing. Okay, the chicken needs a little bit more. The chicken was a little bit bigger, so we're gonna let the chicken cook for maybe another 10 minutes. So next thing is let's prep some avocados for the salad. Cut them in quarters. This avocado is a little too ripe. Excuse me. If you guys are joining in just now, let me know where you guys are joining in from, or if I missed a question that you guys asked and I didn't get a chance to answer it. Just ask me now, please. All right, so I'm just gonna cut my avocado. I have a quarter piece. And I'm just gonna slice it, but not all the way through. So that way I can fan it out, and I'll show you guys. So when I sliced it, but not all the way through. And then that way you get like a little fan like this. So I'm gonna do half of a small avocado per person because it's some good protein. Actually good fat, not protein. Okay. I'm gonna get a platter to start putting my salad out. Each person will get what they like. So I'm gonna dress my salad. This is the dressing, the cilantro lime dressing we made earlier in the beginning of live. I'm just going to start with half of it because I don't want to overdress it. I'm just gonna use my hands because it's easier. Just gently dress it. I don't want like too much dressing. And I'll add a little bit of salt in here too. Like I need a tiny bit more, one more spoonful of dressing. Try a piece. That's good. Definitely needs a little bit more salt. For sure. Let's add a little bit more salt. You guys are being quiet. Or did I, am I missing? missing all your questions. Oh, I'm missing all the questions. Oh my gosh. Okay. It takes exactly the same time to cook eggs in a regular water than the pot. You know what? For me, I don't have to watch the eggs. For me, the eggs come out perfect every single time and easy to peel. So, I mean, you do you. If you don't want to use an Instant Pot, that's awesome. But I've never had a problem with my Instant Pot. Como es el lugar para comprar avocado? What's the best store to buy avocado at? I buy it either at Fred Meyer sometimes, Winco sometimes. I mean, whatever store has it, I'm on sale. It's, you know what matters? It doesn't matter where you buy it, it just matters how. Sorry, okay, hold on. I'm just going through. You can put in chives, you can put in basil, you can put in whatchamacallit. Yeah, I would say chives or basil. I would not add anything. Like, I would not do parsley because I don't know if that would be good in this dressing. But oh my gosh, it smells so good. What brand knife is that you're using? This is Shun. And I'll do a swipe up link for this knife and a couple other ones that I showed you guys earlier. So this is how I'm gonna show you. Dill. You could totally use dill. Maybe do like dill and chives together or green onions. Totally use that for the dressing. If you're like, I don't like cilantro, you know, some people don't do cilantro. But I'll show you guys how I choose my avocado. So always, like this one is like perfectly ripe right now. It's like firm to the touch, but yet like has like a good, what's the deal with that? I know, that was me on Monday. And then in the store, like I'll usually pick off this, call it the butt. Hold on. This actually came in a bag of small ones, so, but I'm gonna just show you guys. So if it's, let's see, I'm gonna flip this over. So see how it has bright green? So if it's bright green like that, that means it's perfectly ripe, and if it doesn't have like those little black dots, little black dots indicates that the avocado is too ripe and it has gonna have those little stringy things. So that's how I choose an avocado. And whenever I find avocado like on sale, I'll buy like the rock hard ones and I'll put them in a fridge. Because keeping them in the fridge will, oh my gosh, the time's almost up. Keeping them in the fridge actually prevents it from ripening. And then when I need it, so see, perfect avocado. And when I need it, I will just take out the avocado and let it ripen with like some sort of fruit. So there's your tip of the day. Hi. I'll probably have to, maybe I'll just do another live just to show you guys, like a quick live to show you guys what the salad looks like when it's done. Actually, I'm just gonna do one, like a quarter, cut in a quarter. Of course. You're welcome, Rebecca. Okay, salad is almost done. I know it's taking me like an hour to make a salad, but we made a lot of things in an hour. Cooked eggs, cooked bacon, cooked chicken. You just have to have good ripe avocados. And right now I'm having like a hard time with this avocado. But you just don't slice all the way through. This one is maybe a little bit too ripe. And I just cut thin. Oh yeah, I just totally butchered that one. That's fine. Cover that like that. Anyways, I'll see you guys on the next live in just a few minutes. I'll tell you guys what the playlist is when I get off. So I'll see you guys in just a few minutes. Make sure you come join and I'll show you what the salad looks like. All right, I'll see you soon.